Good morning. I am Dr. Ranjith Kumar from PGI in Chandigarh, India, and I am going to speak about the role of endoscopic ultrasound in diagnosis and staging of carcinoma gallbladder. And I have nothing to disclose. And carcinoma gallbladder is an aggressive and a lethal cancer with an overall survival of being 5 to 10%. The reason being the late presentation and an yearly spread by lymphatic hematogenous or direct route and high propensity to seed peritoneal surfaces after a tumor spillage and lack of effective therapy. And the aim of the study is to assess the role of endoscopic ultrasound in staging of carcinoma gallbladder and to find the extent of tumor involvement, including the T and N stage of the disease. The study was conducted in the Department of General Surgery, Gastroenterology, and Histopathology in PGI, Chandigarh, India, and it was conducted between June 2013 and December 2014. And it's a prospective observational study with a total of 25 patients included in the study. All patients clinically suspected to be a case of carcinoma gallbladder were included in the study, and all suspected patients underwent endoscopic ultrasound and CT. If needed, patients underwent a PET CT to rule out any metastatic disease. And while performing an endoscopic ultrasound technique, the echo endoscope was inserted into the second portion of the duodenum, and the extent of tumor infiltration and the lymph node metastasis were examined during careful withdrawal of the instrument from the second portion of the duodenum. And this picture shows the different layers of the GB wall as seen via an US, with the first layer representing the mucosal layer, which is hyperechoic, and the third layer, which is hyperechoic, represents the serosa, and between them is an hypoechoic layer, which represents the lamina propria, muscularis propria. And the picture on the top left shows T2 disease with the outer hyperechoic layer irregular, but it is intact. And in a T3 layer stage, the outer hypoechoic layer is not intact. And in the other one, T3, there is complete erosion of the serosa layer with extension of the tumor beyond the serosa. And the lymph nodes are considered malignant if three or more of the following criteria were present. If there is a round shape, well-defined borders, and the location within 5 mm of the tumor, or diffuse hypoechoic echogenicity is present, and a short axis diameter of 5 mm or greater. And the results are out of 25 patients, there are 20 females and 5 males, and the mean age of the patients were 53 years, and the more common symptom is pain abdomen. Among these 25 patients, 12 were operated and 13 became inoperable patients. And in the 12 operated patients, the mean age is 59 years and pain abdomen is a common complaint. And among the inoperable patients, there are 13 patients who are most commonly females, and the most common symptom is jaundice. And this table shows the T-staging comparison between EUS and CT among the patients who are operated. And in this, pathological T1 and T2 were exactly find out by EUS. And among T3, EUS has a sensitivity of 83.3%, which is compared to CT, which had 66.7%. And CT understaged one patient with T1. And among the 4 benign patients, EUS exactly find out benign cases in 3 patients. And CT also picked up 2 patients. And there was understaging misappropriately diagnosed as T3 as by US among these patients. And this shows the comparison between T1, T2, T3 among US and CT, which shows US has a better sensitivity compared to CT. And among N stages, in N1 disease, understaging was done by US in one patient, and as commonly by the CT. And in N2, both US and CT did not pick up any involvement of the tumor. And this shows both US and CT involvement among regarding N stage. And US versus CT in the stage mapping of the patient. Both stage 1 and stage 2 were exactly identified by US, and in stage 3, there is understaging of one patient by US, and in stage 4, both US and CT understaged one patient. And among the inoperable patients, T3 was exactly found out in relation to CT. Among the T4 patients, for 3 patients were understaged as T3 by US in respect to CT. And in the nodal involvement, there is understaging of US in respect to CT. This shows both CT and US has a similar relation in T3. And in T4, US understages compared to CT. And in the nodal involvement, N2 nodes were found to be understaged by US in comparison to CT. This picture shows the staging of US in relation to CT. Most of the patients were understaged in relation to CT while examining by an US. And in this stage 4B, US understages the three patients compared to CT. And this picture shows the sensitivity and positive predictive value of both EUS and CT comparatively, which shows a T1, T2, T3 tumors were having EUS having a higher sensitivity and positive predictive value in relation to CT. And in N0 and N1 nodal staging, both sensitivity and positive predictive value are almost similar between EUS and CT. And in conclusion, EUS is useful in evaluating the depth of tumor infiltration, with a good correlation between the US finding and the HPR results. However, it had a similar accuracy in detecting nodal staging between with CT. And there may be an erroneous diagnosis if there is any inflammatory changes involving the lymph nodes. So US can be used in supplementary to CT for a best T staging of the patient and also in suspecting the end stage. Thank you.